This is part two of an easy way to find the trig functions of special angles, and we're going to do the following seven problems on this video. Alright, we're going to continue with more examples of easy way to find the trig functions of the special angles. Find the exact value of each. So let's start off with this first one, the cosine of 300 degrees. Alright, so I need to find out where 300 degrees is. That's over in quad 4, and let's see. If I went to 360, it'd be all the way around. So it's like got 60 more degrees to go. And remember what you do. So there's where the angle is. You want to drop it to the x-axis. So this is a 30-60-90 triangle, right? And I always exaggerate the sides. In the 30-60-90, the small side is 1, and the long side is 2. And notice in the x direction it's going positive, so it's positive 1. And the y value, the longer leg in this case is square roots of 3, but it's going down. So I'm going to write negative square roots of 3. Remember, I'm using that loosely to make it easy. So the cosine is going to be the x over the hypotenuse or radius, so it's going to be 1/2. And that's the cosine of 300 degrees. Alright, the next one, we'll do the cotangent of 180 degrees. Alright, that's over here on the x-axis. The order pair is negative 1, 0. So remember, that's your x, and that's your y value, and the radius is 1, right? But for the cotangent, it's reciprocal of the tangent. The tangent's y over x, so remember the cotangent is x over y, so it's negative 1 over 0. But what's negative 1 over 0? You can't leave an answer like that. You would say this is undefined, because you can't have a 0 in the denominator. So notice I'm putting my x over my y. That's how I got that. Alright, next problem, sine of 1,305 degrees. Alright, that's more than 360, so let's subtract until we get a number, subtract 360 until we get a number between 0 and 360. And I could say I'm going to be able to do it more than once. How about I do 720 and see where I'm at? So if I subtract 720, it doesn't matter how you do this, you have 5, let's see, the way I do this is 585, still too big. Subtract 360 from that, and I get 225. So 1305 really ends up at the same place as 225. So the sine of 1305 is also going to be the same thing as the sine of 225 degrees. So let's see that picture. That's over here in the third quadrant, and that's a 45 degree angle. So remember, it's 1, 1, and square root of 2, but if it's negatives, like if it's going in the negative direction, which it is for the x and the y, you have to put the minus signs in front of it. Okay, so it's negative 1. I'm using these negative signs loosely, remember. I know that there's no length that's really a negative 1. So how do we get the sine? We take y over the hypotenuse. So it's negative 1 over square roots of 2. Negative 1 over square roots of 2. Now, that is the sine, that's the exact answer, but if you had rationalized the denominator, you would have negative square roots of 2 over 2. Remember, you would get that by multiplying the top and bottom by square roots of 2. Okay, so that's if you rationalize the denominator. Of course, that's really the same thing, just haven't rationalized the denominator. Alright, next problem. Let's do the secant of negative 210 degrees. Alright, so I need to go in the negative direction. Let's see. Going that far is 180, and I've got 30 more to go. So here it goes, right there. Okay, it's an exaggerated 30-60-90 triangle. Let's label the sides here. I'm going to get rid of that. Alright, so that's going to be the negative square roots of 3, remember, because it's going to the left, but the sine is positive, the y value is positive, and the longest side is always 2 in the 30-60-90. Now, the secant is the reciprocal of the cosine. So remember, the cosine is x over r, so the secant is r over x. So we just look at the picture, And we do r over x, 2 over negative square roots of 3. Now it looks funny to leave a negative sign in the denominator, so I usually write that as negative 2 over square roots of 3. Or, if you rationalize the denominator by multiplying the top and bottom by square root of 3, you would write that as negative 2 square roots of 3 all over 3. Minus sign could be up there in the numerator or right in front of the fraction bar. Let's do the cosecant of 750 degrees. Again, this is over 360, and in fact it's over 720, so let's subtract 720. This will end up at the same place that 30 degrees is. So the picture here is, it's at 30 degrees. We drop that right angle. And so the lengths here, and I'm going to put positive or negative if there was a negative direction. We've got square root of 3 for the long leg, 1 for the short, 1 and 2 for the hypotenuse. And I want the cosecant. Now, remember the cosecant is the reciprocal of the sine. So the sine is y over the hypotenuse, which would be 1 half. The reciprocal will be 2 over 1. So the answer to this one is 2 over 1. It's just the number 2. All right, let's do the cosine of 270 degrees. All right, 270, that's right here, right if you go on around, where the radius is 1. And the ordered pair here is 0, negative 1. And the cosine is the x over the radius of 1. So that'll be 0 over 1, which equals 0. And that's the cosine of 270. All right, the sine of negative 420 degrees. Now what you can do here is add until you get something that's positive, or you can just add 360 and you'll still have a negative number and find out where it's at. But you've got to find out where negative 420 is. How about if I add 720? So if I add 720 to negative 420, I'm at 300 degrees. So I know this is the same as the sine of 300 degrees. Somebody else may have added 360 and they would have written, found out it was at the same place as negative 60 degrees. But those are both in exactly the same place. It's right here. Okay, so different ways to find out where that angle is, negative 420. All right, here we've got a 30, 60, 90 again. So let's label it. Let's see, the short side over here is 1, but it's going down. So I'm going to put negative 1. And the hypotenuse, oops, is just 2. And the longer leg is square root of 3. And the sine is the y value, which in this case is negative 1. Over the hypotenuse, so it's negative 1 over 2. Hopefully you're getting the hang of these. Aren't they fun once you know how to do it? So I'm going to stop here. I've done 7 problems. Keep in mind this is just one way of doing it. I find it easiest. I don't memorize anything except the two special triangles and knowing the ordered pairs that are right on the XY axis. So just one way of figuring out the exact trig functions of the special angles.